we want to cover this with a veneer, and I have a few pieces left here of this. This is some crotch walnut, these are the pieces that are, you know, making up the skin to go on to that. So they've just been cut out with a veneer saw, basically four pieces of pie that make a big enough, cover that skin. Now then, what I have to do also is I'm going to cut this little curvature right here and put on another piece of walnut that's linear in its grain. So I'll show you that. I have a piece right here. So this then will be going across that direction and have a little arc, and then it'll make the full arc on the outside of the little deck that's covering. Got some places that are kind of wanting to fall apart. So what I'm trying to do here is make all the points come together where the, you know, different grains and different pieces of veneer intersect, and they have to intersect, you know, pretty close to that edge at each of the four, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different points, and then right here where they radiate, you know, you want that to look kind of like you intended to be, however it ends up being. I have these pieces all, you know, these were the outer perimeter here, the little crescent that goes in there, the little banana. So those are all taped together, and now I've cut it just about an eighth of an inch bigger on the front and on the back edge here. And so when it's done, this is what we'll have. This is the glue side that will get laminated to the core, and then the other side will look just like this when I remove all the tape after it's laminated. Alright, so we will have a veneer piece, a skin, that decorative one, will go on the face of our little deck, and when you glue something on one side, you need to do a balancing sheet on the other side. So this is just some kind of plain veneer, walnut veneer. It is going to go on the back side of this, our deck. So I'm just going to cut that now, slightly larger, and and that'll glue on the bottom, and that will go on the top. Okay, so I'm mixing up the epoxy adhesive to glue the veneer on the core over there. And my face is dirty because of the Wengay sawdust from my arm. What I've got is I use a West System epoxy resin and a slow hardener. And then that's just about the consistency of thin syrup. So I'm putting in an additive called colloidal silica, which is just this really weird kind of fluffy powder. And when you get it all mixed up, you can get it to be the consistency of caulk if you want, but I just want it to be like glue instead of syrup. So I'm just getting this all mixed. And it's all mixed thoroughly with color. I've also added some colorant, brown, so that it's, you know, it kind of helps to fill the inclusions in that veneer. And then when I get this all mixed up thoroughly, I'll add the catalyst, or, you know, the hardener, and then I'll hurry up. Yeah, it's here. It's all measured out. So anyway, once it's all catalyzed, then you need to get it on pretty quick. Once this epoxy gets spread out and it's thin, even putting it in the rolling pan is—it's going to slow down the curing. When it's deep and, you know, in a large mass like this, it cures very fast. Hot, smokes, it's nasty. In fact, I can feel it getting kind of warm right now. So we're going to put that right here. And that's going to slow it down, just the fact that it's in a pan instead of deep in a can. Alright, all right, so what I've done is I've actually put the, so this is kind of dark chocolate consistency or color. I've kind of taped that down to my call board, the finish skin, the face skin, and that way when I put this on, it will, I can index it exactly where I want it, because once it's all, the sandwich is all made up, then I'll tape it so that it is less likely to move and slide. Second, the tape is going to start breaking, and that's okay, because all it was
old bag that I cut in half, and it's got some problems, so I have to clamp it so it doesn't leak.
Now we see if we've done everything correctly. Okay, I'm just gonna undo the, turn off the vacuum, and then we'll take this guy out of the bag. Good, I waxed everything. It's sliding already, so it's not stuck. That's nice. Okay, there's the bottom. Okay, which we kind of care about, but it's all flat and nice, and here's the top. And you can see where the epoxy has, you know, I colored the epoxy, so it's come through the glue seams, which is good. Then there's no chance of anything getting, you know, hooked or whatever. And yeah, Phil, looks really good. I think we're good. So you might recall that there was tape on all these joints, veneer tape, holding everything together while it was in the press. When it came out, there was, you know, tons of epoxy that had been pushed through the veneer in various inclusions, including the seams. And so I'm glad for that. I don't know why sometimes people don't want the bleed through, but anyway, it helps to fill things from the backside, inclusions and so on. But anyway, sanding this all out, I just start with 120 grit, a 120 grit disc on a DA sander, all right? And that's how I get it cleaned up to the veneer. No stroke sander, no wide belt sander, everything, that's as power as I get. And that's as coarse as I get, 120. Doesn't take long, and then move on to 180 and 220. Okay, so I've done the so anyway, excuse me, just sanding with the 220 now by hand, and there's still, I see a couple of little inclusions, all right, and I know I'm going kind of across the grain in places and with the grain in places. I don't know what you call with the grain when you're talking about crotch, this crotch figure, but anyway. So you can see there are some dark lines, and I've used a dark colored adhesive. I've colored the epoxy, and so when this gets finished, you know, it all is kind of part and parcel to the whole thing, but that's how she'll look basically when it's got finish on it. That's just lacquer thinner.